For many attendees of the State of the Nation address that was delivered by President Yoweri Kaguta Museveni yesterday at Kololo Independence Ground, there were key issues they expected to be addressed. Among the issues that dominated the address is corruption and bribery. The president revealed that now he has obtained absolute proof of this vice and that is going to act on the matter. The level at which corruption is thriving in the country could be noticed while the president gave testimony of corrupt officials even in State House, some of whom he says are before courts of law. With the ongoing soliciting of seeking chance for a censure motion against the four parliamentary commissioners alleged to have engaged in corruption, legislators too were eager to hear the president make a pronouncement on the matter.
I've been getting good information about corrupt actors among the public servants, but also among the political actors. With firm evidence, we shall crush these traitors.
However, for Government Chief Whip Hamson Obua, he insists the action to be taken against the embattled commissioners should be left to the president, since he now has full proof of the alleged corruption cases.
The best we can do now is to leave it up to him, with the proof that he has, to take action as the head of state.
For Honorable Sechikubo, the mastermind of the censure motion for the parliamentary commissioners, he sounded energized by the president's address on the matter of the alleged corruption by the commissioners of parliament.
Yachikakasizo bujulizi abufunye nti obubbi n'obukenuzi biyitiridde mu parliament awamu ne ministry of finance. Kakati ffe nga baka ba parliament kitujjeeko omusango ku bye tubadde tujja twogera.
Many of the legislators were optimistic that since the president has got proof of the corruption undertaking in the public sphere, action is going to be taken. They, however, objected to the act of amnesty for the suspects as suggested by the president.
Being united alone without hard work cannot make us get what we want. Do not be discouraged by all the noises around and wherever and actions of detractors and enemies of progress.
Education officials in Wakiso district have decried low staffing for primary and secondary schools in the district compared to the number of learners. The district education officer for Wakiso, Frederick Chiinji Chinobe, says this is likely to compromise the quality of education offered to learners. Chinobe said the most worrying of all is that the district chief administrative officer has assured them that there is no money for recruitment for more teachers. Speaking during the meeting with parents, teachers and stakeholders, Chinobe said some of the schools in the district have only 3 to 4 teachers.
Masomero gabo na basome aga primary ga basome sabo abamu bafa abalala baba ku mirimu ebage.
The district CAO Malinga Alfred, who was also present in this meeting, emphasized that there is no extra budget for recruitment of teachers in the district. He says he only has funds for paying salaries for existing staff.
So the recruitment process is on for replacement basis. So what we are doing right now is to analyze our budget, the current budget, and compare with the indicative planning figures that has been given for financial year 2024-2025 to see.
A Gaza hospital said at least 37 people were killed in an Israel strike Thursday on a UN-run school that the Israel military alleged housed a Hamas compound. The Israel government spokesperson David Mesa said during a press conference in Tel Aviv. The raid came after US, Qatari and Egyptian mediators resumed talks aimed at securing a truce and hostage prisoner swap in the nearly 8-month war triggered by Hamas's October 7th attack on Israel. The military said it had eliminated several militants in a precise strike on a Hamas compound embedded inside an UNRWA school just before 2 a.m. in the Nuseirat area of central Gaza. Israel accuses Hamas and its allies in Gaza of using schools, hospitals, and other civilian infrastructure, including facilities run by the UNRWA, the UN Agency for Palestinian Refugees, as operational centers, charges the military deny. The Al-Aqsa Martyrs Hospital near Nuseirat said it had received the bodies of at least 37 martyrs from the strike. Hamas, in a statement, decried a new crime against their people, urging international pressure on Israel to stop these brutal massacres.